Tonight on Postmodern MTV, the B-52s, Morrissey, 10,000 Maniacs, and a friend of mine who's in much better shape than I am. Thanks for staying up late. My name is Tim Sommer, and this is Postmodern MTV. This is my friend Michael. Michael says hello. All this week, Michael is going to be my special guest. We're going to be talking about different things that he's up to. We're going to be talking a little bit about R.E.M. We're going to be talking about some of the issues he's concerned with. Why am I saying all this?
Because I'm wearing the t-shirt.
That's an issue.
I don't have to talk.
But tonight, especially on tonight's show, we're going to try to do stuff where we're going to show videos that are somehow politically correct.
PC.
Yeah. Is that like the common
PC,
phrase?
PC, yeah. Personal computer. That's politically correct.
B-52s, are they politically correct?
They do great videos.
Now, someone like asked me this, said
they're
the
B-52s. Vegetarian.
They got these big bouffants. Doesn't that require like hairspray? This is a letter I got. I got a letter from Postmodern that said, what do they keep their hairdos up with?
Aloe vera and colanders, I think. Colanders.
Now, this record that we're going to see a video off of, they made it at the same time, around the same time you made your record.
Yeah, we were in Woodstock, New York at the same time, swimming in creeks and talking about music.
Now, I was there too, but I didn't go swimming with you.
We're in better shape than you are.
This is true. This is called Channel Z. It's from the B-52s. That was the B-52s. It's called Channel Z. Throughout the show, we're going to be showing some of the films, the public service announcements that have been made for your film company.
Yeah, C-100.
Yeah. How long has that been going?
We've been going for about a year. We've been making small films, and now we kind of concentrated on public service announcements this year.
So we're going to be seeing a few of those like throughout the rest of the show. Now, you're wearing a special T-shirt today.
Boycott Exxon. Yeah. Yeah, those guys pulled out last week. They said they weren't going to do any more cleanup, and you know, I'm reading in the New York Times about beaches that have 3 feet of sludge still left on them and the bald eagles with the broken wings because they're contaminated with oil. I think it's not a job that's been finished yet. Yeah.
Now, this is, you've been bringing this up in the shows?
I talk about, yeah, I ask the audience every night to join us in boycotting Exxon, Gillette, whatever company is particularly heinous. But Exxon, of course, have kind of proven themselves with the whole Alaska thing to be one of the worst American corporations of the decade, I would say.
Yeah. And the audience is a response to that?
They always clap, yeah. I think people are really for it.
Yeah. Now, this next video we're going to see Morrissey. I think
Morrissey.
The first line in the song goes, there's some bad people on the rise. Is that the line?
I thought that was a song about werewolves.
What, interesting drug?
Yeah.
Oh, that's an idea. Have you seen the video for this?
No.
Okay, it's like, well, you're going to see it, and it's really brilliant, because it's like all this mixed imagery about, like, boys in high heels and a woman who could be a stripper but hands out animal rights literature.
Morrissey.
Yeah. All right, so this is Morrissey. It's called Interesting Drug. That was one of the PSAs from Michael's film company, C-100 Films.
Yeah,
C-100. Or just C-100.
C-100.
We're going to be seeing more of those later in the show, plus some more videos and more of Michael.
Powerful looking weapon you got there, Slim.
It's got to be Slim, what I'm after.
MTV presents Colin Quinn in his first full-length special.
I'm going back to Brooklyn. Brooklyn. I'm going back to Brooklyn.
Man, I don't think so.
And a new sport.
Hi, welcome back to Postmodern MTV. This is Michael. He's waving. I'm just chatting away. We saw a PSA before, a public service announcement. Which is some of the things you're doing with C-100 Films. Who's the filmmaker who did that one?
Tom Gilroy. He's an actor from New York.
And can you tell us about some of the other public service announcements you've done?
Yeah, we've done one on We've done one pro-choice, we've done one on recycling, we've done one on historic preservation, we've done one on organic produce and farming. We're going to continue doing them. Hopefully we're in contact with KRS-One from Boogie Down Productions. He might be doing one for us soon.
On what issue?
It's up to him.
He has like this incredibly valuable experience of having actually been a homeless person, I think. Is that
for
right?
For 7 years, I think he was on the streets.
That's remarkable.
Yeah, he's a pretty amazing performer. Spokesperson.
What else is going on with C-100?
We just released a film called Lighthearted Nation. We're putting out a compilation of an independent filmmaker from Brooklyn. And we're forging ahead into the 90s.
Is there a way people can see this stuff, like Lighthearted Nation?
Yeah, Lighthearted Nation is out commercially. You can buy the video yourself. And a lot of it, hopefully, will be shown on MTV, on other stations, PBS perhaps, independent cable stations.
We have another video to show.
Which one?
It's from The Call.
Never heard of them. Sorry.
Well, The Call, I think they're from California.
California.
They sound a little bit. You two like them, right?
Pacific like Coast.
The romantic Pacific Coast, south of Alaska.
Terrific.
It's called Let the Day Begin.
Call. That was a public service announcement about recycling and trash. And I think next up we have 10,000 Maniacs video.
10,000 Maniacs after this break.
Natalie.
Rate the 80s.
Yeah.
Welcome back to Postmodern. I'm Tim. This is Michael.
Michael.
We're going to see a new video now from the 10,000 Maniacs. It's called E for Two. It's directed by Adam Bernstein, who's a guy I worked with. He directed the Hugo Largo video.
He did?
Did you ever see that?
I saw it. Yeah, it was good.
Adam is a really great director.
You look great in it.
I have really short hair. Yeah. I have really short hair in it. And this is a video that sort of deals with an issue that you've covered in one of your PSAs.
We did a public service announcement about it was pro-choice. We gave it to MTV. They couldn't show it because it's very powerful. But so is this video. Kind of deals with the same side of the coin. And they're going to show that.
Yeah. It's good to see that Adam Bernstein, who has a vocabulary of a lot of wacky imagery, like his Beastie Boys video was full of like big breasts and like stupid clothes, and our video was full of some silly stuff. And the Day Might Be Giants video,
stupid clothes.
The Day Might Be Giants video he directed is also a lot of really silly imagery, and it's nice to see that he's getting down to do some like serious work. This in the B-52's video did is real nice.
Yeah, I like that one. It was great. Yeah. This one is wild.
Eat for Two, 10,000 Maniacs. Ten Thousand Maniacs, Eat for Two, a song that is about...
Pro-choice.
Pro-choice. That about wraps it up for tonight's edition of Postmodern MTV. Michael's going to be here with me for a few more days. You should tune in tomorrow night at 12:30 Eastern and Pacific time, if you're not in the East or in the Pacific.
Eastern Pacific, I'll be somewhere in the mid.
Tomorrow night, Michael's going to
get a direct question, Tim.
Going to talk a little bit about some of the films that he's made with R.E.M. and some of the other people who have made films with R.E.M. I'm Tim.
Michael, boycott, Exxon.
See you tomorrow.
Tonight on No Pomo, my special guest Michael Stipe and a little bit of his audio and visual. Hey, I'm Tim Sommer.
This is Postmodern MTV. It's kind of late, but thanks for staying up. We're going to make it worth our while, right?
Yeah.
Do you ever watch TV at 12:30 at night?
I don't have a TV set. I don't deal with it.
Tonight we're going to look at some of the videos Michael's worked on and some of the other videos, directors that he's interested in, who's done stuff for his band.
Eric Darnell.
Yes, which is behind us even as we speak. He's a student, right?
He's a student at CalArts. He's done one film. I saw it. I called him up. It's showing behind us. Called him up and said, I want you to do our next video. I like what you do.
But what we're going to see now is an old R.E.M. video. It's called Fall on Me. Was that the first thing you directed?
It was the second thing I directed, but the first thing we don't talk about.
Oh.
Yeah. This is great.
Where did the images in this come from?
I told people that we had made a small miniature set based on the essays of a German surrealist philosopher from the 30s. But in fact, it was in quarry in Indiana.
What were you doing in Indiana?
Recording.
Recording.
Live search pageant. Yeah.
That's what this is off of, right?
There's a typo in this video.
Try
to find it.
All right, here it is.
Thank you.
Follow Me, that's from R.E.M. In that video, you use like really big letters, which has been a big part of your imagery since then.
Yeah, we throw them up on the screen behind us when we play live. People can read stuff. They can read about Greenpeace and the groups that we bring on the road with us. They can read all the things that I don't really want to say, like, welcome to the show, we're glad you came, don't throw things at us, that kind of joke.
No, you're like, you've been on stage sometimes, or have you ever been on stage and like you said something and you said, I can't believe that came out of my mouth.
Yeah, I once said something and it was so incredibly horrible that I stopped the show and said that was a stadium gesture. It was my first in 8 years and I apologized for it and the entire audience applauded me.
Were there when you're in a tiny club though, like maybe 8 years ago, did you like, were you like doing stadium gestures and like?
I decided in 1981 that if I ever put my arms above my head or if I ever put my legs further apart than a foot and a half, that I was like putting forth a image of you know, the sexy rock star, and I didn't want to do that. But now I've kind of come around to, you know, I realize that my job in rock music is to make political activism sexy. And here I am.
Speaking of sexy political activism, we're going to see a video called Get Up.
Get Up.
This is your latest video? Yes.
Posture. Get Up. Yeah, this is our new video. It's coming out. MTV's going to play it a lot. Eric Darnell did it. CalArts student.
A remarkable process, right?
Yeah, he takes, I don't think he probably doesn't want me to tell how he does it, but it's pretty atavistic. It's going back.
Keep on going? Okay. So we're going to see Get Up. It's from R.E.M. and Eric Darnell. Stipe, Tim Sommer, Post Modern MTV. After the break, one of his videos, it's called Stand.
MTV presents News at Night. Your world.
Your world.
Your news.
You don't get another quarter.
Welcome back to Postmodern MTV. Michael tells me to sit up. Well, if I can just look on the monitor, I can see this says get up, which means like sit up. This is Postmodern MTV. This is Michael. This
Mike.
Is
Timmy.
Mike, Timmy. We're going to see something called Stand. This is a really embarrassing question. Have you heard Weird Al's spam?
Who? No.
Weird Al.
No.
He put out this album and he does this parody of Stand. Well, the really funny thing about it.
We'll see a video now.
Stand in the place where you live. Now there's no think about direction.
This is Tim Sommer. More fun stuff coming up on No Promo.
Is coming. Did you miss out on the videos of
Thank you for watching Postmodern. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all.
How many years?
No, come on. This is real.
How many years?
Three and a half.
Since you
hair grows really fast. I'm a vegetarian. I don't eat, you know, lots of greens. Let's see a muscle, Tim. Come on.
Is there a direct correlation between hair growth and vegetarianism?
Apparently.
Oh, apparently. But you were.
How are you doing? Your hair got really long.
Yeah, it grows really fast. Yeah. You remember me when I had really long hair.
Talking about hair. This is really rich.
Like two queens here, like talking to like. We're going to see a film called a film. Yeah, you can call it a film.
It's a film. I introduced a song as a film the other night. It's kind of embarrassing.
This one's Finest Work song?
Yeah, great video. I did it myself.
All by yourself?
Yeah. I had some help.
Who are the people in it?
Friends from around Georgia. One guy from England who was there to photograph me.
People in really good shape in this video.
Great, great gems. Great gems.
Okay. Yeah. Let's watch for that. It's
Beating
called
on the World.
Finest Work Song. A video directed by Mr. here. It's called Finest Work Song. You've directed videos for other bands, though.
Yeah, I have. Downey Mildew, Henry Rollins. I'm working on a few things right now.
Anything you want to talk about?
Nope.
Okay. Is that going to be for C-100, or is this like under a different...
C-100. A lot of it is going under C-100, which is, of course, separate from R.E.M. And the R.E.M. stuff I usually run through C-100. Yeah. The Talk About the Passion video was C-100 video.
That's a good video.
You did that?
I didn't know you did
Jim Cohen did it.
Okay. Now that's like a real, like, play him a pretty song, but like, sock it to him with images.
Hit him, yeah. The plight of the homeless.
We're going to be back tomorrow night, the same crew, different t-shirts, same pants.
Posture.
Bad posture me, good posture him. That's it for Tuesday. We'll see you tomorrow night. 12:30 Eastern and Pacific time.
Tonight on No Pomo MTV promo, videos from Robin Hitchcock, Throwing Muses, and Mr. Timmy Sommer.
Michael, Tim. They probably didn't like that with the mics. Anyway, this is Postmodern MTV. Michael's with us again. It's a Wednesday night. Michael here is on stage 2 hours every night, right?
Yeah,
is that about right?
Yeah, 4 nights a week. It's my job. It's what I do.
So, like,
I do it well.
When you look out there and there's, like, the sea of faces, are you, like, pretending you're playing to one person, or you're, like, do you pick out, like, little people?
I look for the redheads. No, I tell you, if you're at a concert, be tall, be blonde, wear glasses, because they reflect the lights, and you'll always be spotted.
Always be spotted.
That's a trick, yeah.
Do you ever like see someone way, way up in the like the top in the blue seats? And
yeah, I
like
see their silhouettes and I can tell if they're leaving or not.
And what do you think to yourself?
They never leave.
They never leave.
They always stay for the last song.
On tonight's show, we're going to play music from some of the bands that have opened for R.E.M. through the years.
Yeah.
The first one we're going to see is from Robin Hitchcock, who's actually done a couple of tours with you, right?
Yeah, he's done a number of them. He's a good guy. He's tall. Really tall.
He's played on stage with you as well, right?
He has, yeah. But it's always songs that I don't know, so I like grab the tambourine and go get a drink, water.
And he sings?
He sings.
He sings.
He's
and
a singer.
He sings in this one too. Robin paints too. Robin's an all around like good guy. He's on tour right now, I think like playing acoustic. Well,
I don't know. I've talked to him for a while. We don't really talk, we write letters.
This is Robin Hitchcock. It's called Balloon Man. Postmodern MTV. After the break, we're going to see videos from 10,000 Maniacs and more of Mr. Stipe here.
Action! This is Robert Townsend.
I'm Mel Gibson.
This is Alfred Hitchcock.
I am Dan Aykroyd.
Jeremy Short.
It's Wednesday night. I'm still Tim. This is still Michael. See, it's late because you're yawning because it's like
yawning.
Really late.
I'm stretching. Stretch like a dog.
Yeah. Now, when you like go out in front of these big audiences, and you think, well, are they're listening to my politics? They're listening to this or that. I mean, do you think about that?
Like, yeah, I do.
What they're getting out of it?
I think it's a pretty important role that I play. I mean, in pop music, which is pretty low on the ladder of important things, you know, if you're going to get out there and sing or do something, you got to be able to present something a little bit better than Axl Rose or Public Enemy. Those guys, you know, what are they talking about? I'm glad that they have their opinion. I'm glad that they're able to express it, but I don't want to hear about it.
Yeah. So is it?
I'm a good guy.
10,000 Maniacs are good guys, too.
That's right.
Yeah. Now, this video, What's the Matter Here, do you know what that's about?
It's about child abuse.
I think I knew that.
Yeah.
So here it is from 10,000 Maniacs. It's called What's the Matter Here? Thank you.
You are watching No Mo, Pomo, Promo MTV. Stick around for those Rhode Island people with blowing meters.
Live, uncensored, and coming.
You can see a quarter something special coming up to MTV. We brighten up your picture and we send you on your way. So don't forget to turn to us, MTV today.
Welcome back to Postmodern MTV. That's Michael. I'm Tim. We're going to show you something now from the Throwing Muses. I don't know if you've ever noticed this about the Throwing Muses. I mean, they're on tour with you right now. And I say this is in a nice way possible because it's not a derogatory thing to say, but they are the world's shortest band. Have you noticed that? No, you haven't noticed that.
They're beautiful
people. Yeah. They're incredible musicians. They play their guitars like no one has played guitars. They happen to be really short.
They make lovely, lovely noises.
AC/DC's almost.
I short. Watch them.
Now, when you play these shows and you're like thinking about your issues and everything, is it like discouraging or encouraging to think, well, I speak about this stuff and I speak about that stuff, but then I open up Spin magazine and then they're
no.
And in their readers poll, they voted me, I think it's called the ninth most dateable dude.
Most dateable dude, yeah. Just underneath Tim Sommer of MTV.
Oh, you've been reading the mail?
I've been reading the mail.
How long are you going to be on tour with Throwing Muses?
They're going to be with us, I think, through this week and into next week. And then we pick up NRBQ, and then we pick up Pylon.
Oh,
and then it's over, Thanksgiving.
So Pylon, I'd heard that they weren't doing this anymore, but they are?
Pylon have rejoined as a band, and they're on tour with us.
Oh,
soon.
Good. Yeah. Opening band's always been a real important thing to R.E.M.
We've always picked our own opening bands, and we've always tried to pick people that we thought were pretty interesting. The Minutemen were probably the most far out in terms of acceptable to a crowd that would come see our show. But they went over great.
Now, the thing we're going to see is off of the last Throwing Muses album, Hunka Papa, which is their best album and a really amazing piece of work. They really brought it together on this.
I think it was Hunk Papa.
Hunk Papa?
Hunk Papa. Yeah, no, there's no A in there.
I'm sorry. Yeah. This is called Dizzy, which is kind of, I guess, like has Texas imagery in it, which is kind of neat.
It's a great video, I think.
From Throwing Muses. Throwing Muses, that was called Dizzy. That's almost wrapping it up for Postmodern MTV. T-shirt, Michael.
Direct piece.
Splain?
That's it. Take something old, make it new.
So what are you doing now? You're on the road.
I'm going out to sing.
See, that's like the equivalent of like a stadium gesture for me to say to you, oh, you're on the road.
What do you do? You're on the road, yeah.
It's like something like Carson would say.
I've been on the road for a decade, you know, it hadn't really changed that much.
The band's going to be 10 years old soon, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is that really unreal to think about?
It's unreal to think about what kind of birthday party we're going to have for ourselves, anniversary, whatever, nothing, probably. Yeah. Flat Duo Jets?
Flat Duo Jets.
Yeah.
Great band, Flat Duo Jets.
Jim Cohen, one of the guys from C-100 Film Corps, is doing a video for Flat Duo Jets, which are on the Doggone label, which is Mr. Jefferson Holt.
So we should tell people, about, they should watch out for stuff from C-100 Films.
C-100, yeah. Boogie Down Productions, Throwing Muses, 10,000 Maniacs, Robin Hitchcock, Tim Sommer, Michael Stipe, Tim Sommer's new band.
I will have a new band.
Which will be covered heavily in Spin, no doubt.
Spin? I didn't even think of that.
The magazine.
Well, Michael.
It's hard to read. Tim.
Thank you for doing this.
Thank you for having me. We shake hands.
Just like a picture.
Love each other.
Tomorrow night, I'm going to be here all alone.
Sorry.
I'm going to be here all alone tomorrow night, 12:30 Eastern Pacific Time. Once again, Michael, thank you. We'll do this again. Bye-bye.